I'm Abhishek Rijal. Currently, I'm a freelance WordPress web developer. I have worked in different themes, plugins, and custom products for WordPress for about 3 years now. And I'm also a WordPress educator. I'm a tutor at the institute in Kathmandu of WordPress theme development. And this is my URL. Maybe you can see. So starting my presentation, I'm going to go through the very basics, from the very basics. What is Gutenberg? So actually, the project Gutenberg is the project that was set back, I think, 1-2 years ago, 1 year ago, that was going to change the default WordPress editor, the tiny MCE editor that we know and use currently in the WordPress. So the WordPress is getting an update, a major update, and in the WordPress 5.0 version, the Gutenberg editor is supposed to be embedded in the core, and the interface, the layout of what we see, is what you get. The WYSIWYG editor will be updated into a new Gutenberg editor. So this is a quick screenshot from the new Gutenberg editor, and you might also have already noticed that if you are updating your WordPress regularly from the 4.8, the latest version, it is also showing the pop-up to try the new Gutenberg editor as it has been embedded into the core. Why Gutenberg? Just like, So why do we need to update the editor into the new new editor? So there are a few points that makes the Gutenberg very nice and futuristic for people, for developers, for users to use. And I've listed a few of them. There's a blocks API. The new blocks API is included into the Gutenberg. So it is like the page builder components, page builder that uses different type of blocks to make the layout. The backend, the administration screen of the current WordPress editor, the tiny MCE editor, is going to be replaced by the blocks, and the interface will be using the blocks to create different editor. And we have in context toolbar. The current tiny MCE editor has the controls like bold, italics, list, and different type of alignment options at the top of the editor. So if you are writing content into your website and creating content for your website, you'll have to, if you are in the middle of the section where you need to make some changes or select a certain person and make it bold, italics, then you'll have to scroll all the way back to the top and do the changes. But with the new Gutenberg editor, we have the in-context editor toolbar that automatically shows, pops up when you are selecting a content. So it makes easier for content writers and users to update content into their sites. Also, there are different type of content and layout template available in the new Gutenberg editor. I actually had the Gutenberg editor's small GIF. I don't know what happened with the slide, but yeah, if you have already used or if you have already installed and tried the new Gutenberg editor, then you'll get to know. And I recommend you try it. And we also have the different type of content layout and template that is that can be used to build different page sections and layouts in the new editor. Gutenberg is extensible. I would like to say that it is more extensible and easy to make changes to than in the tiny MCE editor. And also, as it is in the written in REST React.js, so it is also more flexible to use and make different layout. And having React as the language of Gutenberg, it is also really fast and responsive to use. So it's a quick GIF for the new interface of the Gutenberg editor. It's just an embed block. And as we can see here that in the new editor interface, you have the plus icon that lets you insert and sort for the blocks and easily embed contents into the editor space. So this is the new editor screenshot. Gutenberg for developers. So I'd like to talk into this topic a little bit, preface-like. From the very start of the Gutenberg project development, there are a lot of comments about the future of Gutenberg, about the future of WordPress with Gutenberg, because a lot of developers were saying that it would end the WordPress or something like that. And there are a certain reason for that, which I'll get back to you. But what I'd like to say that with the change the WordPress is having in Gutenberg, it's actually upgrading to a better form. So there is also a lot of opportunities for developers, designers, and content writers, and also the WordPress starters to get most out of the WordPress. So for developers, it is given a new way of creating themes and plugins, integrating the new layout. And for the theme, especially, there was also a lot of questions that after the release of Gutenberg in the WordPress core, how will it affect my theme, or what are the features and benefits that I'll get as a theme developer after the availability of Gutenberg. So, for developers, especially for theme developers, the steps that you can integrate your theme into, use the Gutenberg into your theme, is by some steps that I've listed. You can integrate the Gutenberg into your theme by adding the custom styles for Gutenberg, which is a new thing that uses the add theme support function. And you can also create a new theme with blocks layout and blocks design that can be used in your theme templates with Gutenberg, and customize blocks for custom sections in the theme. So this is a quick code snippet that uses the Gutenberg's new add theme support hook. So it is the editor color palette. The Gutenberg editor has a new color palette that lets you add your custom colors into the editor for users to have it. And for that, you'll need to do that add theme support and editor color palette. And it takes the array of different colors that. Also, there is a wide alignment image support, wide alignment support in Gutenberg. So the blocks also will have the possibility to define a wide or full alignment in the wrapper. So for that, you'll need to do the add theme support align wide. And also, the Gutenberg plugin, or when it is integrated in the theme, Gutenberg comes with some default blocks that can be used by the posts and pages. And by default, the CSS styling for the blocks is not loaded in the front end. So to load it, you'll have to do the add theme support WP block styles. So these are the same steps that makes your theme Gutenberg compatible, or that you are using the adding theme support for the Gutenberg editor. Gutenberg for plugins. Actually, there are a lot of plugins in the WordPress repository right now that uses the Gutenberg Blocks API, and that has different types of blocks, pre-built blocks that can be used to make content layout and everything. If you like search in the WordPress repository, plugin repository for Gutenberg, then you will get like many Gutenberg blocks for maps and layouts and custom cards and everything. So if you are in the next section, if you are trying to integrate the Gutenberg blocks in your plugin, I have a quick introduction for the for the blocks, how to register the blocks in the plugin. This is actually a quite old screenshot that I had taken from the Touch Plus website that showed the register, how to register a new block through your plugin or theme. So, but I'll actually add later on the React.js method that Gutenberg uses in. I'd like to talk of something about the rating of the user reviews of the Gutenberg project. If you look at the plugin repository of the Gutenberg and the GitHub of Gutenberg project, you'll find many negative comments and negative reviews from the developers regarding the project Gutenberg. The reason that I find the main concerns for the developer to for the low rating of the Gutenberg plugins that I find is, as developers are concerned about the backward compatibility of the Gutenberg and custom metaboxes and custom fields and premium themes and page builders. Actually, Gutenberg changes the core editor into a new layout, new editor interface. So developers are concerned about the backward compatibility that if developers have already developed a theme and plugin, and the user or the users or site manager update into Gutenberg WordPress 5.0, then will it be compatible with the theme and plugin that has been already installed into the site is the main concern. Also, there was a lot of issues with custom meta boxes and custom fields. If you are using ACF or any custom field plugins, you might have noticed with the current version or in the development version of the Gutenberg plugin, there are a lot of issues regarding the custom fields. And that's what made developers give the bad rating in the Gutenberg plugin. And also the premium themes and page builders. A lot of WordPress sites are built on page builders and premium themes, and developers are concerned that their content will break and their site will be halted if the Gutenberg plugin is installed. But as of now, I think we have WordPress 5.2 beta 4 released for testing, and while I tested it with different type of custom field and meta boxes, the meta boxes and custom fields are currently in the working stage, and they are also preparing for the preparing for the updates that would support all of the that would resolve all of the issues. So before further learning, I'd like to add a quick note. If you are a site manager, site admin, or currently operating a WordPress site, I would like to recommend some of the steps that you might to check before updating into the WordPress 5.0 with the Gutenberg editor. That if your theme and plugins are all compatible or not before upgrading into the WordPress 5, and if you are using the custom field suite and ACF like plugins, you'll have to check that everything is updated before the WordPress core. And regarding the premium themes and plugins, the premium theme companies and the plugin companies are also looking into the Gutenberg development process very closely, and they are also committed to release an update that is compatible with the Gutenberg plugin. And there are also, I read the blogs from the Avada theme, the one of the most popular theme on the theme forest, and the ACF, that they are also upgrading and releasing update about the update for the support of Gutenberg in their products. So I think you might need to check that before updating to WordPress 5.0. Further learning about Gutenberg. Actually, there was supposed to be a quick introduction of the Gutenberg, and if for them who have at least tried or tested the plugin in the WordPress. If you want to learn more about the Gutenberg plugin, and especially for developers, if you want to learn more about the blocks, the REST API that the Gutenberg uses, then you can check the handbook. The Gutenberg handbook is the new handbook, a developer's guideline in the WordPress.org section. And Project Gutenberg on GitHub that also lets users to see different type of changes, the issues, and everything that users that you can learn from the repo. And also the WP Traven, I think most of the developers already follow the WP Traven for WordPress related news and everything. It is a very good site, and it lets you keeps you updated with all of the changes that's happening in the WordPress community and also related to Gutenberg. I had put some source code example for the plugin to get the blocks. I'll also share a quick link with these are the references that I have taken and questions maybe. Mike.
Hello. Currently, we are not allowing custom blocks in theme of Gutenberg custom blocks because I'm leading WordPress theme review team.
Yeah.
And as our discussion, we are not allowing custom blocks in theme, Gutenberg custom blocks. What do you think about that? For reference, what is your opinion about? We need to allow custom blocks in themes or not? Can
yeah,
I have
actually,
your
thank
feedback?
You for your question. Actually, yeah, that's a good point. The content creation is always been a major, like, review theme review guideline thing. So maybe for now, I think we can switch to plugins rather than building the blocks into the theme. You can like make an additional support plugin. The theme might use the plugin as a. We already have that like companion plugins and anything for the blocks. So. After your theme is installed in the site, you might recommend the companion plugin, and that might resolve the issue regarding. So for now, if you are willing to integrate the Gutenberg blocks into your theme, I would recommend creating a plugin to pass the theme review, maybe. Anything more? Thank you. So if you'd like to talk about Gutenberg or everything or presentation, I'm available outside or somewhere for a networking session. And thank you for your time.